Okay guys, well today I'm going to show you how to tie a green grasshopper. For this fly you're going to need green 6-0 thread, a piece of green hackle, a piece of this thin green chenille, and some turkey feather. First off, you're going to take your thread, you can start the head of the fly, head of the hook, and you're going to go all the way back to the back of the hook. Just trim off the excess then. Then you're going to take your green chenille and you're going to tie it on back here at the end of the fly, and then wrap halfway or just a little bit more up the hook. You're going to take a chenille and you're going to wrap it up to where you stopped your thread. Once you get there, just tie it on and cut off the excess. Next, you're going to take your turkey feather, and what I like to do with this is I put some fly head cement on the feather just so that the strands stick together, and then just cut it off and then just kind of like that and just square up the end then. And then you're just gonna tie it on right over top of where you just tied that, and then just tie it down, and then you're gonna take this and just hold it and use your straight scissors and cut on a 45 degree angle. Turn the fly. You can cut on a 45 degree angle just past the end of the hook. So you're going to cut on a 45. So you have something like that. And then you'll come back on the other side and do the same thing so that you have a point. And those are your wings. I forgot to mention, but you're also going to need a pheasant tail. And for this, these are going to become the legs. You're going to take one strand like that, you're going to tear it off, and you're going to tie it in a knot in the middle. It's a little bit tricky, so I have some already made up, but then you basically get something that looks like this. You have a knot in the middle, and it makes a crease, or a it bends the little piece so you have a bend, and then you're just going to tie it on the side of the fly like so, and then you'll have to twist it so it's on the right way. Then you'll do the same thing on the other side with the other one. You have to twist that one as well. The legs are the hardest part to get right. Here's something that looks like that. Then you can just trim off these up here. And then you're going to trim off just a little bit of the leg at the tail end. So you just cut them off the same length as well, and just make sure they're on the right side and that the legs face down. So you might have to just move them around a little bit to get them where you want. Then you're just basically going to wrap over that whole thing. Next, you're going to take your hackle feather and just trim off the end, pinch that, and then trim it off, and then pull off so you have just a little bit of a strand there, and you're going to tie that on over top here. And then once you have that, just wrap all the way up to the front of the fly. Then wrap your feather around the hook. So these are basically going to be the front legs and also a little bit of the head of the fly. And just wrap all the way up to the front. Once you get there, just tie it down. Make just a few wraps over that. Kind of build up a little bit of thread in the front, just for looks purposes, like it's going to be the head of the grasshopper. Just trim up any loose ends there. And then you're going to take your whip finish and make a few wraps with that. Pull it tight and then just cut off your thread. Make sure to take your flathead cement and put a little bit on your needle tool and just put it over the head of the grasshopper where you just made the knot. And there's your grasshopper.